Hello everyone, welcome to Geeks for Geeks. In this video, we are going to see how we can handle the null values in our dataset. So sometimes what happens is our dataset contains some empty cells, and those cells we call it as the null values, and we have to handle those null values because we can't provide null values to our model, to a machine learning model. That's why we need to handle them. We can either fill these null values with some value, or we can drop such rows, or we can either replace them, right? So we are going to see a few methods how we can handle these null values. So first of all, we need to create a data frame. So for that, we need to import pandas. So import pandas as pd. Let's run it. So my pandas is imported as pd. And for this video, we are going to use the Bangalore house prices dataset. So first of all, let's create a data frame called df is equal to pd.readcsv bangalore.csv. And you can download this CSV file from the link in the description. Now let's see the first 5 rows of this data frame. So df.head. Let's run it. And I can see the columns, the features of this data set. And let's say we have to analyze this complete data set. So for that, first of all, we need to check what is the shape of this data set. So for that, we can do df.shape. So this is going to return me a tuple which will tell the rows, comma columns. So this means that this complete CSV file contains 13,320 rows and 9 columns. And you can also see that 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9 columns are there, right? Now this dataset may contain some null value, right? So we have to analyze it. So for that, there is a function called df.isNull. And this function is going to return me true or false. So it returns basically the Boolean value. So wherever in this data set the null value will be there, then it will be true, either it will be false, right? So let's run it. So I can see that mostly it is false, but I can see some places, at some places it is true. So this true means the value at this cell is null, right? You can also see over here it is NN. NN means null, right? Now I don't want this complete true false thing. I want a total number, right, for every column. So for that thing, what you have to do is you have to run a function called df.isNull.sum. And let's run it. So column wise, it is giving me that area type column contains 0 null values, location contains 1 null value, size contains 16 null values, and society column contains 5502 null values, right? So this gives me the total sum of the null values in each column. Now you don't want it to be in column wise also. I want a final number. I want a scalar value, just a number, right? So for that thing, you will just copy this line and you will paste it and you will do a sum of this also, right? So let's do a sum and let's see. So total 6201 null values are there in my data set. Perfect. Now what is my task? My task is to fill these null values, or we can drop these null values, we can remove these null values, or we can either replace these null values with some other number, right? So first thing that we are going to see, let's put a markdown, and over here I'm going to put filling the null values. Filling null values. Let's put it this way. Yes. So first thing we are going to do, how we can fill these null values. So for filling the null values, we can use an inbuilt function called fillNA. And that we can use it by writing df.fillNA, and you have to provide a value in this as a parameter. So this value equal to 0 means wherever the null values will be present in my data set, 0 is going to replace them, right? And now we are going to create a new data frame called df2, and it is going to contain my new data frame, right? Because I don't want to affect the original data frame that is containing the null values, right? So now let's check df2. And let's run it. So I can see that at this point, it was a null value in the df. But here in df2, I can see that it is 0. And everywhere, wherever it will be true, that means wherever it was a null value, now in this df2, it contains 0. Let's check it, whether df2 contains any null value or not. So what I'm going to do, df2.isNull.sum.sum. And when I'm going to run it, I can see that 0. But if I run df.isNull.sum.sum, I can see that again 6201 values are there in the original df. But in DF2, there is no null value. Why? Because I have filled those null values with 0. So this is how you can fill the null values. Let's do one more thing. Let's fill it with another value. Let's fill it with, let me copy it, let me paste it, and let's make it DF3, and let's fill it with 5. So I can see that instead of 0, it has now filled it with 5. Perfect. So now you know that what is df.isNull. Sorry, df.fillNA, right? Now let's do one more experiment with df.fillNA. So this is my original data frame df, and here is one of my null values. Now what I want to do, I want to fill this null value with just a previous value like this. I want to fill this null value with the previous value. Now how I can do it? So let's put a topic, let's put a comment, filling null values with previous value. Right? Now you have to define just another parameter. So let's create a new data frame called df4 is equal to df.fillNA, and you have to define a method, and my method will be, you have to define PAD, that is pad, right? So it is going to fill the null values with just a previous value. Now let's run it. So let's print df4 and let me run it, and I can see that where it was null, it is now filled with the previous value. Now let's do a quick verification whether my df4 contains any null value or not. So df4.isNull.sum. I can see that no column of this df4 contains any null value. Perfect. Now the next task is to fill the null values. Let's first of all print df, which is my original data frame. I can see that it is having the null values. Now we have seen how we can fill this null values with the previous value. Now I want to fill this null value with the coming value or the next value row wise, right? So next row value I want to print over here, right? So what I can do is, let's copy the same thing, let's paste it over here. Now my topic is filling null values with the next value. Right, so let's create df5. Method is going to be bfill, that is backward fill, right? So let's run it, and I can see that instead of the null value, I'm getting the next value row wise. Perfect. So we have seen how we can fill these null values using pad method, using backward fill method, right? So let's do a quick recap of these two methods. In pad method, we fill the null values with the previous value row wise, but in the bfill, that is backward fill, we fill the values with the coming value, right? With the next value row wise, right? Now we have seen filling the null values call row wise, right? What I was doing, I was filling this null value. Let me come to df. I was filling this null value with this value by pad and this value by backward fill. But now I want to fill this null value with a previous value, but column wise. Or the second method will be filling this null value with the coming value column wise, right? So let's see how we can do it. We don't have to do something unique. We just have to define fillNA only. df6 is equal to df.fillNA method is going to remain same, that is pad. But my axis will be 1. Let's print df6. And I can see that my null value is filled with the previous value but column wise. Let's do the same thing. And let's make the method as bfill. And let's change the data frame number. And let's print it. And here I can see that the null value is filled with the coming value but column wise. So this was how you can fill the values, a previous value or the next value. Now we have something more in fillNA method. So let's see the df first. So this is my original data frame. Now what I want to do is, My task is to fill a null value only, but I want to fill a different value in society column and a different value in this balcony column, right? Now how I can achieve it? You have to do fill NA only. So let me put the comment, filling null values, filling different null values, filling different values in null in different columns. So what I can do is, you have to write df, let's create df 8 is equal to df dot fill na, and over here you have to define a dictionary, and inside this dictionary you have to define a key which will be your column name. So let's take the column name as society, and in society you want to fill this with, let's say, abcd, right? So let me put it in a string abcd. And the second column name is balcony. So let's copy it and paste it. And here you want to fill the null value with defg, right? So let's print df it and let's see what we have got. So over here I can see that in society, my null value is filled with abcd, and in balcony, my null value is filled with defg. So here I can see that how I am filling the null values for different columns, right? Now let's see the next thing. Now here what I want to do is, I want to fill the null value with the mean of the complete column, right? So here I can see that this column is a numeric column, right? 1, 3, 3, 1, 0, like this. So here I want that this null value should be filled with the mean of this complete numeric column, right? So here let me put the topic, filling null value with the mean of a column, right? So what I can do is, I can create a new data frame, df9 is equal to df.fillNA, and the value, that is a parameter, is going to be df at, and here you have to define the column name, that is balcony, put it over here, and you can just define dot mean. That means the mean value of this complete balcony column will be filled at the null places, right? So let me run it. So let's print df9. Let's run it. And I can see that in balcony, I can see that there is no null value. Why? Because that null value, which is at position 13316, 13316 is now filled with the mean of this complete column, right? So it's totally up to you. You can also fill this with the max. So let's print it max over here and let's run it. And I can see that at 13316, it is now filled with the max of this complete column, right? You can also fill it with the mean. So let's fill it with the min. That is, the minimum value will take the place of the null places. So here I can see that at 13316, it is 0, because 0 is the minimum value in this complete column. So we have seen the method fill any, that is filling the null values. Now the next thing we are going to see is drop NA. That is, we are completely going to drop those rows, right? So what I can do is, I can put a topic. So let me put a markdown drop NA method, right? So let's see first of all the original data frame df, and I can see that this, that is fourth index row, is having a null value. Then I can see that the 13316 row is having a null value, and it is containing two null values, by the way, and I can't see it more, but there will be more null values also, right? And I can see at index number 2 also there is a null value, right? Now if I'm going to run a function called df.dropNA, and let's df.dropNA, and let's save it in df10, and let's run it by printing df10, I can see that index number 2, then 4, then 13316, and like this, any row that is containing even one null value is removed from our data frame. So this simply drops those rows which contain even one null value, right? I hope you are understanding. Now the second thing that comes in drop NA is a parameter called how, right? So I'm going to do the same thing, that is df11, df.dropNA, but you have a parameter called how. and in this how parameter you can define multiple things. Let's see what we can define. So I'm clicking on shift plus tab and click on the plus icon, and you can see in this how that we have values, two values we can fill, that is any and how, all, right? Any means if any of the cell in that row will be null, then that row will be removed or dropped. But all means if all the values in this complete row are null, that means null, null, here also null, here also null, everywhere null will be there in that row, then and then only that row will be removed. Otherwise, it will not be removed. So let's print it all and let's print DF11. I can see that index number 2 and 4 are still there because they don't contain all the values null. They contain only one value null, right? And if I print it any, I can see that 2 and 4 are not there. Why? Because they contain at least one null value, any null value, right? So this was how we drop the null values using the df.dropNA function. Now the third function that we are going to see in this video is df.replace, right? So let me put the markdown, and the function name is replace. So here, as the name is suggesting, we have to replace the null values, right? It is almost similar to fillNA, but here we get some extra functions. So let's see what we can do. So we have to create another data frame called df12 is equal to df.replace, and we have a parameter, first parameter called toReplace. That means what we want to replace. So here we have to import numpy because I can't write none like this, null like this, right? So we have to import numpy as np because numpy contains an object for null values, and here we can write np.nn, right? So we want to replace the null values, and here you have to define which value you want to replace with the null values, right? So here I have to write value is equal to, let's print it, this number. So wherever the null value will be there, it will be replaced by this number, right? So let's print df12. And here I can see that index number 2, it was containing a null value, but now it is containing this number. And at index number 4, it was containing a null value, but now it is this number. Here also 13316, it was having a null value, but now it is containing this number, right? So this function has replaced all the null values with this number. And you can put anything, right? You can put any number. It will replace the null values. And using this replace function, you can not only fill the null values, you can not only replace the null values, but you can also replace any value. Let's say I want to replace 3. So here I can see that balcony is containing a lots of 3s. So wherever I'm getting 3, I want to replace them with 5. So let's do it. So df.replace to replace 3 float number with a value 5.0. Right, let's create another data frame, df13 is equal to, and let's print it. So this is the beauty of the replace function, that it is not restricted to the null values. We can replace any value with another value. So let's print it, and I can see that wherever 3 was there, now it is 5, right? So this is the beauty of the replace function. Now the last method that we are going to see to fill the null values is df.interpolate. So let's put the topic interpolate. So as the name suggests, it uses different methods to interpolate the values. It interprets the values, right? So let's say my data frame is containing a column with the values like 1, then 2, then 3, then 4, and I can say that it is having a null value like this, and it is having 6 over here, it is having 7 over here. So this is a very basic example, and this interpolate function is going to interpret these values, and it is going to fill this value automatically by 5, right? And there are various methods in this interpolate. So as first of all, the method is linear. So it is going to consider those values as linearly distributed, as we saw in this example. Let's say I took one more example as 5, then let's say it is having null value and it is having 6. Null value and it is having 6 over here. So this interpolate function is going to interpret these values, all these values, and it is going to fill the nn value with the mean of these two values. So it will be 5.5. So like this, it is a very useful function for filling the null values. Now let's use this function, and we will use a linear method for filling the null values in balcony column, right? So let's do it. So as we are working on this balcony column, I'm going to call only the balcony column. So df at balcony will be df at balcony dot interpolate. Then you have to define a method, and my method will be linear, and let's try to run it. So let's print df, and we can see that there was a null value at index 13316, and now if I see 13316, it has filled, or it has interpolated this complete column, and it has filled it with 0.5, right? So this is how this interpolate function works. Now you have some more parameters in this. So let's see one more parameter, that is limit direction. So we have a parameter called limit also, so that decides how many consecutive null values you want to fill. Let's say you define the limit as 1, then even if the two consecutive null values are there, only first one will be interpolated. And let's say you define the limit as 2 and there are 3 consecutive null values, then only first 2 null values will be filled, right? So this is the significance of the limit. But here we are going to see the limit direction. That means we have to define whether the limit direction is forward or backward. And here my limit direction is forward. So I'm going to print limit direction as forward. And we can run it. And I can see that all the null values in the balcony column are now interpolated perfectly. So these were some of the methods how we can fill our null values, how we can replace the null values, how we can basically handle our null values. Because why we are handling these null values? Because we can't provide the null values to our machine learning model. So if you want to give us any feedback or suggestion, then you can do that in the comment section. Thank you for watching this video.